I'm Italian, I'm president of the Italian movement Forza Nuova, and I'm happy to preside as well the Alliance for Peace and Freedom. Why is it called the Alliance for Peace and Freedom? Peace is because when we formed the Alliance, we were at the beginning of the war in Ukraine. And as a first statement, we wanted to say there should be no war in Ukraine, because as it was previously in Syria, we recognized there were world power forces coming, especially from America, and especially from the neoconservative Americans, that wanted war at all costs, before in Syria and after in Ukraine. And we thought that as Europeans, the main thing we should say is that there should be no more wars between brother people in Europe. And why freedom? Because in Western Europe especially, there is an attempt to introduce stringent laws against freedom of speech. If, for instance, you try to oppose yourself to gay marriage, you risk to go to prison in Spain, in France, in Germany, and soon in Italy, if you say that the traditional family, the Christian traditional family, is the only possible family. So that's why we called it peace and freedom. And it's a fact that we have been gathering since then movements and parties from all over Europe, and I think we count now 11 nations belonging, 11 groups belonging to the Alliance of Peace and Freedom, from Greece, Germany, Italy, Slovakia, France, and all the others. What we intend to do is quite simple. We want to tell to the Russians that European people want to be with Russia. They consider themselves, because our history is very clear on that point, we consider to be in the same family of people with Russians. I'm a Roman. I was born in Rome, but I know since I was a child that there are three Romes. The Rome I was born, another Rome was Constantinople, that was lost at one stage to Islam, and the third Rome is Moscow, is Russia. Now, this means that the Russian people have a particular role in history, which is to represent the rebirth of Europe and the rebirth of Christian Europe. It's not me saying this, it's God saying that. And it's very clear that the events taking in the world at the moment are showing that the great strength opposing the powers of death, because I think that the American neoconservative, I'm not talking about the American people, which is a completely different thing, but the American neoconservative, which occupy the United States government and the United States military intelligentsia, want war and death everywhere it's possible. So the other scenario in which I see Russia, particularly important is in this fight against liberalism and against fundamentalist Islam. It's not the Arab world. You know perfectly the difference between the Arab world and fundamentalist Islam. I have been to Syria. We met with the Assad government. We know perfectly that from Nasser, from Bourguiba, from the Ba'ath Party, from Saddam Hussein, from Assad, there was a kind of Arab nationalism that was not in conflict with Europe or Russia. He was a friend of Europe and Russia. But what it happened afterwards, he was created like a new currency, a new purist currency, fundamentalist Islam, that broke first the Arab world and now is trying to break Europe. It's a fact that the Caliphate, in the first statements, very clearly pointed at the strategical targets. And the strategical targets, again, is Rome. I'm a Roman, so I feel a bit uneasy about it, and I'm a bit worried about it. And I know that this threat was just in North Iraq, in Syria, and approaching Lebanon, but now it's in Libya, it's in Tunisia, it's in Nigerian and growing up to the north, is a substantial threat that is going to also have a specific danger with all the enormous amount of immigrants that are coming through Africa. And it's a fact that with all the Muslims entering illegally Italy, maybe even 1 out of 100, will hear at one stage the Muslim fundamentalist call to attack Europe, to attack Rome. So that's why it's essential to have an alliance between patriotic movements, people in Western and Eastern Europe and Russia, because we can defeat liberalism and the attempt to destroy family, values, our Christian traditions. And on one side, fundamentalist Islam that is showing its real faith. And the real faith is to destroy European and Christian civilization. So the alliance is very, very important. And I really accept with, wholeheartedly, the offer from the International Conservative Forum to make an alliance with European people and European movement. This is something that is going to destroy the plans of the world mongering faction in the United States. We have to create more and more relations between Europe and Russia, more and more economical relations, cultural relations, political relations, and even spiritual relations between European people and Russia. So this is going to be the beginning, as it was rightly said before. St. Petersburg has been the beginning in another situation in the past, but it's obviously a new revolution is starting. And this revolution is going to be entrenched and embedded in our history, in our profound history. I mentioned the three Romes. I mentioned the strong Christian links. But this is going to be something, a breakthrough, a new event that is going to change European history, Russian history. history, and it's going to change the balance in the world. We are not going to have anymore a superpower in New York and Washington that is going to dictate the law everywhere in the world. We have got to say our position, we have got to state our position, and where you will see Europeans involved in politics, in geopolitical politics, you will see peace